So just we discuss the principle of operation of STATCOM, and also we have seen what is its basic configuration and what are the components. Now let us see operating modes of STATCOM in this session. So STATCOM we have already discussed, it is used for the converting or just controlling the voltage and supplying or generating reactive power, as well as it can supply or absorb real power also. So that two modes of operation we have to see STATCOM, and just you will be understood via characteristics also. So if it is covered in this session, I will take otherwise further session. Next session will be on operating characteristics or VI characteristics. So as far as STAT operation, there are two modes of operation. So try to understand when STATCOM will give real power flow or absorb, it will supply real power flow when leading source voltage to the lagging. So we have discussed when voltage magnitude is different, it will supply or generate reactive power, and phase difference between the two voltages are there, then it can supply real power or absorb real power. So active or real power flows from leading source to the lagging source. Always power flows from leading source to the lagging source. So when phase difference of the two voltages is there, then it will supply or absorb real power. So how in that case real power will flow or active power will flow? It will flow from leading source to the real lagging source. So whose phase angle is leading? Whether voltage source converter phase angle is leading to the system voltage, or voltage source phase angle is lagging with respect to the system voltage. In this case, when there is phase angle difference between the voltage across the voltage source converter and the system voltage, then phase angle difference is there, means magnitude will be constant. So that try to understand. So magnitude is constant, phase angle difference is there, so it will just have absorption or supplying real power. But when reactive power, you know the equation of reactive power, it is V1, it depends upon one voltage and change in the voltage, means difference in the voltage, delta V divided by X. That equation is very important to understand all the principle and operation of the static devices. So that we revise or discuss in first session, that you keep in mind that equation, so you will understand the modes of operations also. So reactive power flows from higher to the lower voltage magnitude. Means we have discussed when voltage source converter voltage magnitude is different than the transmission line voltage. So if voltage across the converter is higher than the transmission voltage, then that power will flow from higher magnitude of voltage to the lower magnitude. In this case, the whole converter, or you can say STATCOM, will supply reactive power to the system. But when converter voltage is less than the system voltage, so power will flow from the system to the converter. So in that case, converter will absorb real power. So this is always from higher to the lower phase angle or higher to the lower magnitude. So phase angle difference between the source decides the active power flow, and magnitude difference decides the reactive power flow. So based on these principles, STATCOM can be used to regulate real reactive power flow by changing the output voltage. So when you can just see, based on these two principles, STATCOM can be used to regulate reactive power flow by changing output voltage. So reactive power flow is by output voltage control, and real power flow is by phase difference control. So we will understand with this how STATCOM works. So basic principle of operation, I hope you understood it, is just repeated 2-3 times. So when source voltage V1, STATCOM voltage source is V1, that it represents the output voltage of STATCOM. Say in earlier session we discussed with that ES, but here now we are considering it is V1. So in case of reactive power demand increases, now what is this meaning? If reactive power demand of the transmission system increases, means that happens with the when load increases. When load is peak load or full load, then reactive power demand increases. In such a case, reactive power generated in the generating system is less. So we need powers, reactive power supplied to the system. So STATCOM generates reactive power and it will supply to the system. So when reactive power demand increases in power system, STATCOM increases its output voltage V1. Why STATCOM increases its output voltage V1? So that power will flow from STATCOM to the system. Because in this case, STATCOM has to supply reactive power into the system because reactive power demand has increased and system its own reactive power generated is less than the demand. And if it will be not supplied, then stability will be affected. So STATCOM increases its output voltage because basic operation we have seen STATCOM output voltage or voltage source converter means it's a variable output voltage. So voltage across output voltage of the voltage VAC has to increase. So STATCOM increases its V1. So to maintain the phase difference between V1. So I told you when magnitude difference is there, we are considering phase angle difference is 0. So real power flow in this case has to be 0. Okay, why real power flow from STATCOM means in STATCOM to the system has to be 0? Because there will be no phase angle difference. But this is in discussion theoretically. But always there has to be small phase angle difference between V1 and V2. So it should be noted that there has to be small phase angle difference V1 V2. Why? Because this will require to supply the leakage or losses of the converter. So to cater for the leakage impedance drop in the interconnecting transformer. So transformer is having some reactance and voltage drop will takes, or in other words you can just say converter has its own losses. To supply that losses, small angle difference has to be there. So V1 is greater than V2. So V1 is the voltage across the voltage VS. And V2 is the transmission line voltage. So V1 is greater than V2, reactive power flow from STATCOM to the powers. So that we have discussed in the operation. This is one mode of operation. So when voltage of power system increases. Now when this voltage of power system will increase? When during night load, that we have discussed in the night load period, or very low load is there. Suppose you can just see afternoon situation. So load is very less, and as load is very less, system voltage, power system voltage will increase. So due to the load throw up, because load will be thrown up in the night or in afternoon, so STATCOM will reduce its output voltage. Why? Why STATCOM has to reduce its output voltage? Means VSC voltage will reduce so that power will flow from power system to the STATCOM. So that STATCOM has to absorb the power because voltage of the system will increase. Parent effect we have discussed. In that case, you have to absorb reactive power so that voltage of the power system will maintain constant. So in this case, the STATCOM has to absorb reactive power to stabilize the voltage to the normal value. So above mode of operation of STATCOM is called voltage regulation mode. So what we discussed with that reactive power flow, or depending upon the magnitude of the voltage, that mode of STATCOM is voltage regulation mode. Because there are two modes of STATCOM. First mode is voltage regulation mode and second mode is wire control. So you should not confuse between wire control, because here when magnitude is different, means V1, V2 magnitudes are different. So you can remember it is voltage regulation mode depending upon the magnitude of voltage. But by magnitude of difference in the magnitude, we are just supplying reactive power or absorbing reactive power. So don't confuse between wire control mode and voltage regulation mode. But when we know every equipment has got their own limitations, because this is a voltage regulation mode, but V1 and V2 cannot be any, because every equipment has its limitations. So V1 voltage across STATCOM has also has limitations of supplying or absorbing reactive power. This means that STATCOM will not supply any reactive power, or any reactive power it will not absorb. It is having limitations, means difference between V1 and V2 has limitations. So why these limitations is there? Due to the current carrying capacity of force commutated devices like IGBT and GTO. So we have seen two types of converters, either GTO based or IGBT. So even if you use GTO or IGBT, that will have current carrying capacity limitations. So due to that, these limitations, that voltage regulation mode has some limitations. So you cannot have any real power, reactive power flow or absorptions or voltage also difference any. So limitations are there. So therefore, if the operation of STATCOM reaches their limitation, it does not further increase or decrease its output voltage V1. This means that STATCOM is having VSC, means controllable controlled voltage source. Even if STATCOM is having in controlled voltage source, your output voltage VN cannot be increased too much or cannot be decreased too much. So it absorbs reactive power with limitations and it generates reactive power with limitations. And therefore, we have to see that there are limitations. So further some limitations of the point, you cannot control V1. This is called voltage control mode, VAR control mode. This mode of operation STATCOM is VAR control mode. Means what? When there will be limitations on changing the voltage, increasing the voltage or decreasing the voltage, then that STATCOM will convert into VAR control mode. So current through the STATCOM will remain same and you will reach the limitations on voltage control. So it is said that there are two limit operating modes of STATCOM, voltage regulations. So when V2 and V1 magnitudes are changed, in this case phase angle will be zero. Phase angle difference between V1 V2 will be zero. So real power flow will be zero. Only in this case reactive power Q will be flowing when magnitudes are different. But as phase angles are zero, difference between phase angle is zero, delta will be zero, so real power flow will be zero. So that is first operating mode. And you just remember reactive power equation V1 into delta V. So delta V between the magnitude of the voltage difference divided by reactance. So this you know, reactive power flow. And real power flow, you know the equation. Sin delta is coming. So that angle delta is coming. So VAR control mode, STATCOM reactive power output is kept constant in the independent. So in this mode, in VAR control mode, STATCOM reactive power output is kept constant independent of the system parameters. So here I told you that voltage regulating mode, when ES is greater than ET, or you can just say V1 is greater than VT, it will supply reactive power, and when ES is less than ET, means V1 is less than V2, it will absorb reactive power. So this is the one mode. So that is we discuss in operating principle. Now to understand this operating operation of STATCOM, two modes here only I am explaining, and then we will discuss this part in the next session. So here what I discuss first mode, now I think you have cleared. So when current will be changed, so this is the current and this is the voltage, y axis is voltage, this is current. So you can just see current is changed, so voltage will change. So this point you can see current is changed. As you will go on changing current, voltage will change. So voltage will also go on increasing, but you can change voltage only up to this limit. So this is voltage regulating mode. So this is inductive side and this is capacitive side. You know that to understand basic phase diagram, you must understand inductive represents positive side and capacitive represents negative side, because inductive absorbs power, so positive. So this supplies power, so it is negative. So first this side is inductive, this side is capacitive, and that now this characteristics is in per unit. So this is full current carrying capability of the device. So one unit means full current carrying. So you can just see this is the capacitive full current, means minus one. Now in the voltage regulating mode, voltage is varied. VSC voltage is varied. So you can just see this part, voltage is varied. So it is having some voltage maximum. This voltage represents some voltage, means minimum voltage you can say, and it will change to the voltage, increase in voltage. So this is the increase in voltage, and when VSC voltage will increase, it will absorb the power. So you can see V2 is just varied here, and this V is varied. So if voltage is varied, current is also varied, and this is with capacitor. So here voltage is varied, current will be varied. So voltage control is only from this to this. means this is minimum and this is maximum, because I told you voltage cannot be reduced too much and voltage cannot be increased too much. So this represents the first mode of operation. But if you see this characteristics represents the second mode of operation, where this is called as wire controlling mode. And in wire controlling mode, current remains constant. So inductive current remains constant, and when it is capacitive, then it is also remaining constant. Okay. And you can just see this represents wire control mode. So here also the same things happen. You can